In chapter 20, section 20.1 is a very qualitative discussion, introduction of integral transform. So I'll let you read instead. I'll go to section 20.2, talk about Fourier transform. So Fourier transform is very similar to Fourier series. Basically, you can treat it like a Fourier series in the continuous limit, which means that the original Fourier series is in our previous formula, we define x is from like from minus pi to pi. So, if we changed instead of minus pi to pi, but like minus L to L, we talk about that, but in sine and cosine form, but in compact form, you can write the Fourier series, like say F X is sum of N from negative infinity to infinity, C sub N, E to the I in X. You can do that. But this is for x from minus pi to pi, but if it's from L minus L to L, we basically multiply by pi here. So change that. Minus n pi x, and then we divide it by L. Okay. And that is for if the domain is changed to minus L to L. Okay, and the C sub N is calculated by divided by 1 over 2 L integrate from minus L to L and the function of X and exponential. Now you choose a negative sign minus I in pi X over L dx. Okay, so this is the Fourier expansion. So it's a Fourier expansion with the coefficient C sub n given by this integration. Okay, now if we let L goes to infinity, so basically we'll consider an infinite domain. Then now because of that, L is very large. So in the argument of the exponential function, L is large. So everything will goes to zero except for N is also large, which means that you need to include many, many N, including N is very large. So basically you need to include many terms here, and all the terms becomes a very densely distributed. So this summation becomes an integration. So basically, let's say this summation from minus n from minus infinity to infinity becomes an integration of dn where n goes from minus infinity to infinity. Okay, so and then the argument has this n pi of L factor, L is going to infinity, and n will also include a very large n. So now instead of calling n pi of L, we'll change that to a new name, new symbol like k defined as n pi over L. All right. And so this integration dn can be changed to dk. So dn would be L over pi times dk. Okay, so now the next step we can think about is this Cn, C sub n. Now, this C sub n has a L in the denominator. So So we can write C sub n. Instead of writing it, because L is going to infinity, we write C sub n times L. Okay, and that is equals to this 1 over 2 integrate. Now L is going to infinity. Okay. Yeah. X e to the minus I k times x dx. Okay. And fx becomes, and sum becomes integration of dn, but dn becomes dk, it becomes L integrating this 1 over pi here. And then you have C in L DK, K and DK from negative infinity to infinity, and then E to the I KX. Okay, and so that depends on your notation. So CNL is, you have a CNL here, the CNL is also in here. And now L can be goes from negative infinity to infinity. So you can write like substitute this equation to this equation. So we have 1 over 2 pi. And let's write this as dk first. Minus infinity to infinity, and Cn has a integration of dx also from minus infinity to infinity, because L goes to infinity. Okay, and then you have this e to the I k times x, but then there's an integration of this one also. But in this integration, when you substitute it into here, you can call that, instead of integrating over x, you can integrate it over x pi. So this becomes x pi minus x pi and multiply by f x pi. Okay, so it means that f x is equals to this, this integration. All right, so and this fx pi integrating over this e to the negative ikx. And you can define a something called a Fourier transform of the function. And say if you define an f, and usually you give it a symbol. Let's see what the textbook is. I think the textbook didn't do anything, just change it to a symbol, but let's use the convention that I think your textbook calls G. Okay, let's follow that. Let's call this a G. Here, define a G sub K. Now, G sub K can have a coefficient, depends on your convention. Sometimes G sub k has no coefficient. Sometimes it's 1 over 2 pi, sometimes 1 over square of 2 pi, like your textbook. If you choose 1 over square of 2 pi, and integrate to minus infinity to infinity dx, and e to the minus I k x fx, this would be called, this is would be the Fourier transform of F. So, and then using this equation, so very obviously Fx would be also 1 over square of 2 pi and dk minus infinity to infinity and e to the I k x g sub k, g function of k. Okay, so Now this integration is an integral representation of the function fx, or you can say that this is a Fourier representation or Fourier integral, or sometimes called an inverse Fourier transform. Okay, and by choosing the coefficient 1 over square of 2 pi, both the Fourier transform and inverse Fourier transform have the same coefficient in front. But if you choose one of them as 1, the other would be 1 over 2 pi, and vice versa. Also, the difference between these two integrals, one would be a negative sign, the other would be a positive sign in the exponential function, and which one is which is depends on convention. And also, this is doing the spatial domain. So I use K in your textbook. In your textbook, you have changed the domain to time. And most people, especially physics people, will define it differently. So the Fourier transform, now instead of K, it depends on omega. And then this would be one over square root of 2 pi minus infinity, infinities, and now it's dt, but we'll choose I omega t and f of t. This is the equation 20.10 in the textbook. Okay, and then this would be the Fourier transform, and the inverse Fourier transform ft would be 1 over square root of 2 pi integrating over the omega from negative infinity to infinity. Now you use e to the minus I omega t and g omega. This would be the Fourier integral for ft. Okay, so this is a different convention for time. The sign is different, but that actually is just a small difference. All right, so by this kind of inverse Fourier transform, we'll look at this equation, and there's one result that we can get quite automatically. So this is just basically because you are doing a dk dx over fx, right? So this is dx prime over this fx prime, and doing this integral. So, and you recover fx, so this means that dk of exponential I k x minus x prime integrate from negative infinity to infinity equals to 2 pi delta x minus x prime. Okay, so this is the completeness condition for Fourier transform. So this an expression of the delta function in Fourier transform. Okay, so so this is a quite useful relation, and sometimes you can also regard this as the orthonormal condition for exponential functions. So basically, in the continuous limit, both equations are exactly the same. Okay, so this would be one useful representation. Okay, so those are the basic formula for doing Fourier transform. And when we're doing Fourier transform, we usually use the exponential form, unlike Fourier series. And in Fourier series, in many cases, we use sine and cosine series. But in Fourier transform, we usually just use this exponential function. But sometimes we can also do a Fourier sine transform or Fourier cosine transform. Basically, it's just exactly the same. If the function f is, if ft is even function of t, then you do a Fourier cosine transform. If it's odd function, you do a Fourier sine transform. So like if f is even function, so is the integrating t from negative infinity to infinity, you do a 0 to infinity, because this e to the I omega t can be written as cosine omega t plus I sine omega t, and sine omega t time f t would be 0 when you integrate from negative infinity to infinity. And the cosine term give you 2 times from integrate from 0 to infinity. So basically you have a 2 in front. So the cosine Fourier transform will be, the formula will be, you have a 2 in, multiplied by 2 and integrate the t from 0 to infinity instead. And you have the ft times cosine omega t. Okay, so that's the Fourier cosine transform. And similarly, you have a Fourier sine transform if ft is odd, an odd function in t, so Fourier sine transform would be 2 over pi integral 0 to infinity dt ft sine omega t. Okay, so this is basically just definition, but mostly we'll do Fourier, just the Fourier exponential function Fourier transform. Okay, so then there are some examples, and we'll go through that next time.